Wednesday, the 21st of December, 2016. Good morning, gang. Welcome to today's United Kingdom Talk. Now, what have you had for breakfast? Oh, look at this. Have you had crumpets? Yum, yum, yum. Have you had crumpets this morning? Bad news, I'm afraid, gang. Researchers have found that some crumpets contain even more salt than 3 packets of ready-salted crisps. Oh, yes. Be careful. High levels of salt are making crumpets a hidden health risk. Not that sort of crumpet, dear. You're probably looking at me after I said that and thinking to yourselves, well, Chris doesn't look like he contains more salt than 3 packets of ready salted crisps. Oh, yeah. Is that what you're thinking? I'm not talking about people, dear. The little bread things that you eat. Eating too much salt every day over a long period is linked to high blood pressure, strokes and premature deaths. The average salt content per crumpet is equivalent to 1.5 packets of ready salted crisps. So do go careful on those crumpets, dear. I mean, is there anything we can eat, you know, other than nuts and bits of fruit or apples? Apples are supposed to be good. Apples hurt my teeth. You know, when you, you know, they do hurt my teeth a little bit. Bit hard for the old false. I haven't got false teeth before yet. Look, all my own teeth. And I was able to nibble away last night at a pizza. I went out last night. I went out with my mate. We met out with lots of people at Pizza Express. I say lots of people. I think it was about 15 of us all together. Something like that. At Pizza Express in London. And last night, again, not bad with the traffic at all last night. Isn't that strange? You would think now the traffic is particularly bad, what with coming up to Christmas and that. And it has been for the last 6 weeks while I've been going down to work. Well, last night, we went into central London and actually only took us 1 hour and 15 minutes to get there. Isn't that strange? So Monday, what we are now? Wednesday. Praise to the Lord above. I'm hoping today, tonight, when I go and do my quiz tonight, it's going to be reasonable traffic as well. I think we've got quite a few groups coming down tonight. Ray Reynolds is coming down tonight to play the quiz, as well as that man. I can never remember his name. That bloke who does the show on a radio station in Essex. Ba-da-ba-ba-ba-ba. Da-da-da-da. It's Essex Radio FM in stereo VHF. Something like that. I think there's a few of them coming down to do the quiz tonight, so I'm looking forward to that. And I hope that the traffic's... I hope it's not going to be another two-hour drive. I've just about had enough of two-hour drives. I must get my car clean today. I've got to get that done today. It is filthy. Absolutely filthy. Now, interestingly, I don't know if I told you this, but my nephew, who fixes car bodywork and does paint, pulls out dents, fills holes, and he's got his own little garage now. I said, no, incorrect. He's got his own unit where he does all this fixing. And he's very good at it. I'm not just saying this because he's my nephew. But my sister would have told me if anyone had a job done and had complaints. And no one's complained. He's very good at it, you know. Very good at doing this. And I was asking him about car washes. And he said the worst ones to go to are the people who have hand car washes. Now, a lot of them tend to be foreign, but that's neither here nor there. Hand car washes. He said, you shouldn't really use a sponge to clean a car. Did you know this? Because I've always cleaned my cars with... I don't really do it myself, but... When I was cleaning my own car, I was always doing it with sponge. He said, that really does put a lot of scratches on there. He said, you're better to go to an automatic car wash. I love that. Yeah. So pretend, would you like an impression? Would you like an impression of an automatic car wash? Would you like that? Look, here we go. So they go, and my head is the car, okay? These are the words, like, and you come back through the other way. And the one on the top. Oh, that hurt my nose, wouldn't it? Let me just protect my nose while it's... That was an impression of an automatic car wash. Please, please repost the automatic car wash impression onto other people's walls. Some people need a smile on their faces, bloody Christmas. What a load of miserable bastards there are around this year. Please stay at home if you're going to be miserable. God's sake, man. Anyway, so my nephew says it's better to go to an automatic car wash than go and get your car washed by someone who uses a sponge. You know, because there's quite a lot of those hand car wash places around. I said, well, hey, what's the best way to wash it? He said, a woolen, let me just see, woolen mitt. Let me see if, woolen mitt car wash. Let me see if anything comes up. Well, wash mitt. Lamb's wool. Look, lamb's wool. £10.99, dear. Buy wool car wash mitt at Amazon. And he says, let's see. Look, you can have a luxurious one for £12.99. Let me see what it says here. Anything on the thing there? Miguel's lamb's wool wash mitt will pamper your... Oh, we do like a bit of pampering, don't we? I wish someone would pamper me. Anyone want to pamper me? I offered yesterday for people to just randomly come up and touch me. And I promised you I wouldn't be taking any of you to court for harassment or anything like that. You go ahead and touch. Did anyone touch me? No. I was so disappointed. Do you know, I hung around yesterday in the swimming pool stroke gym changing room waiting for someone to touch me. Nothing happened. In fact, they threw me out in the end. That I sat there so long, and as blokes came in, excuse me, would you like to touch me? I mean, they give us ever such a funny look. I don't know what's wrong with people. All I want is a little bit of a touch. God's sake. Well, you can also pamper me, boys and girls. Do you fancy pampering me as well? I would like that. Pamper your paintwork, and is ideal for sensitive finishes that mark easily. There you go. So that's what it says, and that's what my nephew said. He's quite right. The best way to clean your car is with a woolen hand mitt, okay? You put this thing over there. I mean, obviously, you've got to be so careful. It must be very careful to pick up a bit of grit or something. And I just washed my car. Oh, no! Have you ever done that? Awful. So he says the best way to do it, if you can't find a woolen hand, people that do use these hand mitts, is to actually take it into one of those automatic car washes. So I might do that later. The only thing with the automatic car wash, they don't do the wheels very well, do they? I mean, they give them a bit of a brush, but that's about it. They really don't do the wheels very well. So that's interesting. How did we get onto the subject of that? Don't know. Here we go again. Chris, we didn't know what we were talking about. Oh, yeah, we were talking about... I know what we were talking about. So, dinner yesterday at the Pizza Express. And, yes, it's coming back to me now. The journey in. Got to wash the car today. That's it. It's coming back to me now. So, we got there. And he told me it was Pizza Express, Charing Cross. Charing Cross. Okay? So, we went... We got to Charing Cross Station. I mean, when you say Charing Cross, I just automatically assumed Charing Cross Station. Okay? So we walked up there, and I couldn't find it. And I rang up. I said, are you far past the pizza? He said, where are you? I said, well, we just walked past Heaven and up. He said, no, Charing Cross Road. So we've gone to a completely wrong place. At which point I said to my mate, I said, well, we're in the wrong place. He said, oh, come on. And we'd parked quite easily. Not easy to park in London. We actually parked like that on a single yellow line. Couldn't believe it. So we went back to the car. So is it walkable? He said, oh, it's about 10 minutes. Well, we got back and he said, we're better off the drive. So we got back. He don't like to walk, my mate. Ron does not like to walk anywhere, dear. Let me tell you that. Unless you're buying him something. In which case, he'll walk to the end of the earth, dear. So we got back in the car. And we were running the car back. I said, we could have walked, dear. We went round the corner. Towards Hippodrome Nightclub. And there it was, next to the Hippodrome Nightclub. I said, well, turn left here. Let's try up here. And my God, next to Pizza Express was a parking space again. I couldn't believe our luck. We couldn't believe our luck. So we parked there, went into the Pizza Express, and everyone was there waiting for us. I think it was about 5 minutes late or something like that. And we had the dinner in there, which was quite nice. I just had a normal margarita pizza. And we had a pudding as well, and which we had free of charge, which was quite nice. And at the end of the night, because we got there a little bit later, we paid our bill. We were going to pay our bill separately. And we told this bloke, foreign bloke. I couldn't understand what he was saying, dear, but never mind. We told him we wanted to pay separately, and he had a separate bit of paper. And then at the end of the night, we had a lovely chat with everyone. I met some wonderful people there. One of the boys there had recently been to a casino, and on the that whirly thing, you know, the thing that you goes round and round and you put a ball in it, and it's red, black, and there's one green one. What's that called? Oh, that turning thing. Roulette. On roulette, he had recently won, are you ready for this? £10,000. £10,000. And I know this because I went to the bar, get a couple of drinks, right? Coca-Cola. I had a couple of Coca-Colas, and my mate had a raspberry lemonade, which I must say looked nice, but it was ever so sweet. I had a little taste of that, and I didn't like that. And he was at the bar, and he opened his wallet, and I saw all these notes. I said, "You've been working hard today." I looked more closely. You know, my beady eye doesn't miss much. I had 50 quid notes. 50 quid notes in his way. He's stuffed like that with 50 quid notes. So I said, "Blimey, where'd you get all that one?" He said, "I won at the casino. £10,000. £10,000. I said, "Well, how much did you have to win to do that?" He said, "About 200. So, you know, you have to remember, you know, he could just as easily have lost £200. And that's a fair old, I think 50 quid is a lot to lose. I think 20 quid is a lot to lose. You know, I was saying to my mate Ron yesterday, my mindset when it comes to money, I think is still stuck in the 80s. I really do. 20 quid to me on a night out sounds plenty to me, dear. Does it you? Are you of an age as well? Would you be upset if you spent 20 quid on a night out? Of course, we don't include things like Barry Manilow tickets. Oh, no. Price is no, doesn't matter. You know, what Barry wants, we pay the money and we go and get entertained. Every penny worth it, my dear. Yes. Sorry, the old voice is a little bit down tonight, as you can hear. It's quite butch this morning, isn't it? The old voice is at a slightly lower level. Not lower as in volume, lower as in tone. Boo. Here is a tone for you. Boo. Yes. Now, where was I? Oh, yes, the money. So you could just he could just as easily have lost that 230 quid, I think it was. But he didn't. He won £10,000. And he went and sat back down again. And I went over and had a quiet word. I said, "Look," I said, "it's none of my business. But if it was me, I'd go into the toilet, take 50 quid out of that wallet, put the wallet back in right down at the bottom of your pocket. And when you're going to buy stuff, just get out that 150 quid note. It's not good to be standing at a bar out somewhere, you open your wallet and you've got all those notes in there, whether they're 20s, 10s, 50s, doesn't matter. You know, you don't know who's looking, oh, he's got all that money. We're right round the corner for him. You know, get something and bash him over the head. It happens. It happens." And he said, "Oh, I'll be all right." No, you might well be all right, but you've got just as good a chance of being whacked over the head. And people don't care. You know, you might get knocked out or you might get killed. They're not bothered, these people. Never, ever, ever, please. And this is for anyone else watching this today. Never, ever get out a load of money. I mean, obviously, you're not, you know, getting out a wad of money like that and showing it. I saw it in his wallet. I was standing next to him. So anyone else could have done it as well. So please, and I'm not going to identify this person. They don't know. I don't think the rest of them know who won the money. But please never, ever take out wads of cash like that. I mean, usually, I take out about 10 quid. And normally, if I'm with my mate Ron, have you got any more money? I've run out of money for the shopping. I'm a bit too far the other way, admittedly. But don't take out thousands and thousands of pounds like that. That's just, you are asking for trouble. Please, please. I'm thinking of you, dear. Thinking of you, OK? So that was that. At the end of the night, the bill came for all the rest of them, long bill, about 220 quid, which worked out to about 30 quid each. I thought that was fair enough. So they've paid the bill and they were going on somewhere else to have a bit of a drink somewhere. I don't like sitting in bars anymore. I really don't like sitting in bars. So we declined to go out for a drink afterwards. Even though, oh, but it's Christmas, you must have a drink. I don't like drinking. I don't like the taste. I don't like the lightheadedness. Don't like it. And some of them, I didn't actually have this last long. But you know when you don't want to drink, oh, go on, have one. Oh, go on, just have one. Oh, go on. No, I don't want a bloody drink. Go away. Oh, no need to be like that. And they go, no need to be like that. Well, if you'd have stopped shouting and telling me I want another drink, then I wouldn't have told you to go away, would I, you idiot? But that didn't happen last night. He just asked me once and said, no, we'll be going home after our lovely pizza, which was quite nice. I have to say it was nice. I just had a margarita pizza with some chilies and onions on it. Ronnie, I think, had the same thing. And so they paid that bill. And most of them went and left just a few there, including Matt, who was in charge. He arranges this thing every year. Matt's a nice bloke. He used to be a DJ as well. He wants to get into DJing again. So we had that and we ordered our puddings. And then they said, well, we can have two free puddings. Oh, right. OK. Oh, well, how's that then? Well, if you have a starter and a dinner, you get a free pudding. And, you know, I didn't say anything. Obviously, we didn't say, but we never had a starter. I said, all right. She said, so without even us saying it, she said, someone here must have had a starter. Or a few people had a starter and they didn't have the pudding. I said, well, do they know? Yes, they know. They just didn't want it. So you two can have it. Oh, fabulous. Free food. Hooray. That's what we like. Free food. Oh, do you like today's Christmas jumper, by the way? Look, anyway, Santa and a clock. Yes, Santa and a clock. Incidentally, the pendulum is still swinging and the light is on today. I know what you're thinking. Where's the Christmas tree? I know. I just haven't bothered to get it. It might not happen. Now, the Christmas tree might not happen. I don't know yet. So we had the pudding and I had this chocolate thing with ice cream and what have you in it. And so we sat there and had that. And most people had gone, as I say. There were about three of them left. I said, can we have the bill, please? Well, you've paid. Oh, have we? You know, you don't want to say to the member of staff you haven't paid, do you? In case someone's made a mistake somewhere. Oh, right, OK. When did we pay then? Oh, you paid with all the others. Oh, right, OK, then. Well, thanks very much. Are you sure about that? She said, well, I'll go and check over there. And she came back. She said, yeah, it was all on the one bill. OK, thanks very much, you know, and she went off. And I said to one, I said, well, they must have put it all on the same bill. And he said, oh, yeah. He said, do you want me to complain? I said, no, leave it, because they might end up charging us twice. If they think we haven't paid, they might try and put it through again. You don't know, do you? So we elected to sit there and say nothing. And I said to Ron straight away, I said, well, I'm not happy about that. That means they, as in the other people, have just paid for our food. So Matt, by this time, had disappeared. And I said to one of the girls, I said, where's Matt? Oh, he's standing outside having a cigarette. Honestly, they were in there for about an hour and a half. Every 10 minutes, they're all outside having another cigarette. God's sake, man. Can you not wait until the dinner's finished? Every 5 minutes, they go down the stairs, have another cigarette halfway through a meal. Please do me a favour, dear. God's sake, man. Anyway, so she said she is downstairs. So I said, OK, are you going out now? Because we're all standing up now. Yeah. Can you ask him to wait for me downstairs? I said, I need to go to the toilet. So I popped into the toilet. When I came back out, he was up there already. He said, what's up, Chris? I said, listen, you've paid for our food. He said, have we? I said, yeah. He said, I don't know how it happened, but they've mucked up the receipt somehow. So I gave him 60 quid. I said, that's for our dinners. I said, I don't know how you're going to work this out. You've got to give everyone a fiver or something. Or why don't you just take the 60 quid and go and get a couple of rounds of drinks, or probably one round of drinks, because there's that 60 quid on a round of drinks. God, isn't that a lot? I said, you'll probably get them a load of drinks for that, and please let them know what's happened so that they know. I mean, God, I would die if people thought I was on a free, freebie mission. You know what I mean? Getting someone else to pay for my food. So I give him the 60 quid. And and Matt says to me, he said, well, thanks, Chris. He said, you could have said nothing. I said, no, I couldn't. I could not do that. I absolutely could not do that. I mean, maybe if maybe it's someone I didn't like, I could do it. Oh, yeah. And there's a few of those. Believe me, if it had been someone I don't like, I probably could have done it. But not with friends like that. You can't. You can't. So I gave them the 60 quid and out they went. So I'm glad that was all sorted. And then we went home. And a really, really nice night was had by all there. All right, let's do today's birthdays, boys and girls. Oh, hang on. We've got some messages to do as well, haven't we? Hang on a minute. We haven't done messages for a while. I've forgotten to do the messages that people have been leaving under the various shows that we've been doing. Angela, good morning, Angela, says, thank you for mentioning me and bum scratching within the same segment. Maybe you were sitting on a diamond and didn't know it. Do you remember we were saying some woman on QVC who's selling diamonds said yesterday, QVC in America, said that no one is allergic to diamonds. You silly old bag, aren't they? Aren't they stupid, some of the people? I don't think I was bum scratching. What it is, I get uncomfortable a lot. Especially in my mate's car. My mate's got a BMW and it's very low down. I get really uncomfortable in his car. And he had a BMW before. It was exactly the same. I'm like this. I'm so low down. I cannot get comfortable in a BMW for some reason. So I was probably just adjusting myself in the car or bum scratch. Let me scratch my bum now for you, Angela. Now, you see if this was the same sort of movement I was doing yesterday. Was it like that? Or was it a bit like that? Because that's me moving on the chair. So bum scratching. Moving on the chair. Bit like that. Bit like that. Bit of a phlegmy cough at the moment, but it's not getting any worse. I've had this for about 2 weeks now. Anyone else got a phlegmy cough? Awful. What else have we got? And Angela then sent me a picture of this gadget. I mean, you've never seen anything like it before in your life, which goes on your head and is some sort of Apira Science hands-free hair growth laser system. And this is something that people put on their head, men and women, and it's supposed to make your hair grow. $545. Are you serious? Once it's gone, it's gone. That's it. Transplants and tattoos on the head, maybe so. But the hair is not growing back. Let me tell you, £545. Free hair growth laser system. Science hands-free hair growth laser. Oh, God's sake, madness, madness. Good morning to Simon, who says, Noel, Noel, you played that song well and get a prize. Thank you very much. And we've got another carol coming up very shortly today. John says, loving the organist's entertain spot. Thank you, John Child. Should become a regular feature perhaps on a Sunday after church. Oh, yes. Hail Mary, full of grace. Rachel says, does that include ice cubes? Ice cubes. Bum, 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 bum. Ice, ice, baby. But I was like Honey G then. Did you see me rapping? Honey G. I say honey. You say G. Honey G. Honey G. Yes. And some messages from a couple of shows ago that I meant to read out as well. Where is it now? Oh, come on. Find it, find it, find it. There we are. Let's on. Kevin. Hello, Kevin. Kevin Webster wants the star illuminated at all times. So there you are, Kevin. That star will be illuminated at all times, especially when I remember to turn the damn thing on. Darren Lee Wick says, Mariella Fostrop is my female crush. I think it's her voice. I've never heard of her, dear. Mariella Fostrop. Don't know who that is, dear. What did she sing? Has she been in the charts? Huh? UK Top 40. Daniel Wolf says, very truth about the age. You don't look a day after 65. I beg your pardon, dear? You don't look a day over 65. And I think you could pass for 60 on a good day. Thank you so much, Daniel. How rude, dear. Are you still living in that little squat in Camberley, are you, my love? Dreadful place, dear. Paul Gallagher says, on the subject of us not looking the same age as our parents did when they were our age, Paul says, your parents definitely looked older, harder lives and just the way they dressed. My sister looked older in the 1980s than she did in the 1990s, mainly because of the makeup and fashion, and they were a lot more aging. Paul also says, you look quite boyish to me because of the clean shave and cropped hair, sir. Boyish. I like that. Boyish. Chris, boyish. Very boyish. I'm very boyish. Thank you, Paul. I'm very, very happy with those comments. Paul came to the karaoke on them Monday night and he was sitting halfway up the emergency staircase. Halfway up the stairs is the stairs that I... It's the Muppets. The Muppets, isn't it, that one? Rachel says, MMDD. Is it MMDD? The Man in Mode Music Polish. The DD bit means donations draw. Now, someone won something from a donations draw. And they've donated it to me. As I am a registered... I should become a registered charity. I will become a registered charity at some point. From Eloise and Rachel and Anne, that is. Which I shall be opening here on this programme on Christmas morning. Ding dong merrily on high. Yes. Let's have a look. Kiki D says, Theresa May, you fancy. Yes, I knew it. Don't worry. Power and status is a great aphrodisiac. I used to have a crush on Donald Trump. Oh, God. What with his fat ass? Oh, no, dear. Oh, there's so much to hold on to, Kiki D, isn't there? God's sake, man. Oh, just imagine. I want you to close your eyes and imagine. Close your eyes. I want you to imagine being kissed, open mouths with tongues, with Donald Trump. Oh, God. No, thank you. Love the Advent hymn. You played it, Come Emmanuel, I think it was. We sang that last night at my local carol service. So thank you for that, Kiki D. All right, darling. We will be doing a carol very shortly. First of all, today's birthdays. Oh, yes. Happy birthday this morning to Helen Thompson, to Paul Robertson. I haven't seen you for ages, Paul. Leanne Marie Crowd. Happy birthday, Leanne. Nigel Moss today is 48 years old, looking fantastic with the old electric guitar. Edward Ross, the lovely Miss Ross. Who is that with you in the photo? Send them over, Miss Ross. Happy birthday, Edward Ross. Keep dragging, my darling. Happy birthday to Michael B. Brooks. Filipa Figueira is 36 today. Happy birthday, Filipa. And Kerri Foakes, lots of girls today, is 24 years old today. Happy birthday, everyone. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, happy birthday, happy birthday to you. All right, have a wonderful day, gang. Now, very quickly, because we're running out of time here, let's go downstairs and play you this morning's Christmas carol. Oh, yeah. Wendy has requested the Christmas carol this morning, and it's Hark the Herald Angels Sing. Sing along, boys and girls.
There's this morning's Christmas Carol. It's a Wednesday night, so join us tonight. And it's the last one of the year, actually. Join us tonight for the King's Head Theatre Bar Quiz. That's at the King's Head Upper Street in Islington, starting at 8:30 and finishing at 10:30. Tonight's music round is Christmas Carol, so brush up on those. And once again, join us tonight. King's Head Theatre Bar for the quiz every Wednesday, except next week, starts at 8:30 and finishes at 10:30. Have a nice Wednesday. Thanks for watching. Bye-bye.